Hello everyone, I'm Siddharth and we are dealing with civil engineering, and in that effective stresses, permeability and capillarity. Now in the previous lectures what we have seen, the basic concepts of total stress, effective stress and the pore water pressure, and also we saw that when the water table falls down, the effective stress increases, if the water table rises up, the effective stress decreases. And when the water table is fluctuated above the ground surface, there is no effect on the effective stress, that there is no change in the effective stress. The effective stress will be carrying the value same as that of the value at when the water table was at the ground level. Now today in this lecture, we will discuss the effect of seepage on the effective stresses. So now, you know, this is how the seepage will occur. Either the water will be flowing down or the water will be flowing up. So what happens when the water is seeping through the soil, the total head means the amount of energy which has to be dissipated, which this results in the head. You know that when water is at a particular height from the datum, if this is a datum, and if the water is at a particular height h1, and in next level the water is at height h2 from the datum, so the water will flow from this point to this point, and this is the total head or the head between between those two points where the flow is occurring. When the water is seeping through the soil, the total head is dissipated as a viscous friction. So this head, which will be lost from coming here to coming here, will be lost in the form of viscous friction, which will produce a frictional drag. When the water flows down, this will be the frictional drag on the soil particle. This is the soil particle. These two are soil particles. So when there is a frictional drag, the frictional drag will push this soil particle downward, which will increase the contact force with the other soil particle. That results in the increase in the effective stress. Now, when the water flows upward, the frictional drag acts in the upward direction, and this makes the particle lose contact with the other one. So that results in the decrease in the effective stresses. Now we have to study the seepage pressure, seepage forces. What is the seepage pressure? What is the seepage force? This total head is also called as the head loss, because this much of head has to be lost while coming from this point 1 to this point 2. Okay, this is also called as the head loss, which has to occur from 1 to 2. Okay, let's see what are the seepage pressure and seepage stresses. So these are the three components which we have to learn. You should remember the formulas for this. Okay. The seepage force is given by B into delta H into gamma W. Okay. Where, what is B and H? If this is a soil sample, this is B into B, and this is 1. The water is flowing from here to here. Okay, the water is flowing from here to here. This is B, this is 1. Delta H is the total head which has to be lost between the two points where the seepage is occurring. The seepage pressure is given by the head loss between, if I take any point on this plane and this plane, A and B, the head loss between A and B is delta H. The seepage pressure is given by, simple, B into delta H into gamma W divided by the area of soil. Will be taken from the upward area, the B into 1. This will be gamma W into delta H. Simple, you have to remember this formula. No need to revise all this. And delta is the head loss. Seepage force per unit volume of the soil will be B into delta H into gamma W upon B into B into 1. This will be delta H by B into gamma W. Delta H by B is given by small I into gamma W. Small I is the hydraulic gradient. Just correct this. This is the B and this is A. This is 1, this is A. The thickness of the soil is 1, the area of the soil is B into B. This is I. The weight of the soil will be acting downward, this will be acting this way. It can be in any direction depending upon the direction of flow. You just have to remember this formula, and this formula. Now we will get into the analysis part, the analysis of seepage force, how it is affecting the effective stress. Let's see. There will be three cases when the water is at static condition, that is hydrostatic condition. The second part will be when the water is flowing downward. The third part will be when the water is flowing upward. First condition is no seepage. This is also called as hydrostatic condition. Okay. Now let's discuss it. We will take 3 points. A, C, B. We have to find out the pressure head, elevation head, total head at all the points. We will see. Okay. Now if I want to insert a piezometer over here at A, if I insert a piezometer at A, the water will rise in the piezometer up to the water table because this is the hydrostatic condition. If I insert piezometer at C, the water will rise again up to the water table. Now if I insert the piezometer at point B, the water will rise again up to the water table. We will assign some heights to it. If I take this as H1 or capital H, this as H1, this height as Z. This is complete soil. And if I want to draw the total stress diagram and pore pressure diagram, the total stress will be how much? If I draw the total stress at this point, the total stress will be 0. At this point, the total stress will be because of this height, gamma W into H, H1. So I will draw gamma W into H1. Now at point C, the total stress will be how much? Gamma W into H1 plus gamma saturated soil into Z. This will be gamma W into H1 plus gamma sat into Z. And at point B, this will be how much? Gamma W into H1 plus gamma sat into H. If I draw the pore pressure diagram will be how much? Gamma W into H1 at this point, gamma W into H1 plus Z at this point, and gamma W into Z plus H1 plus H at this point. This is the U. Okay. Now we'll draw a table and see the pressure head, the total head and the elevation head at different points A, C and B. Okay. Now let's draw the table. This is sigma, this is for you. The table will consist of four rows of points. What points we are considering? What is the pressure head? What is the elevation head? And what is the total head? Okay, first we will start with taking the bottom level as the datum. So if I take points A, C and B, at point A, what is the pressure head? Pressure head is of the water, the pressure head will be H1 because the height of water in the piezometer is equal to H1, so I will write H1. At C, it is equal to H1 plus Z. At B, it is equal to H plus H1. Okay. Now, at the elevation head at A. Elevation means from the datum, what is the height of A? The height of A from the datum is capital H. In plus, because it is above the datum. If it would have been below the datum, the elevation head would be something minus. We will see, just wait. Elevation head of C, what it is, this much height, H minus Z. The elevation head of B will be 0 because it is at the datum only. Now the total head is, just add it, H1 plus H, H1 plus Z plus H minus Z, that is equal to H1 plus H. Then again it's equal to H plus H. Fine. Now if I take my datum, my new datum, I will write it with the red marker for the new datum in the brackets. I will write the pressure head in the brackets for the new datum. I am taking my new datum at point where the A is present. So the pressure at A will still be H1 because it is not affected by datum. The height of rise in the piezometer will give the pressure head. So this will be H1. Again, this will be H1 plus Z. This will be again H1 plus H. Now the elevation head will change. The elevation head depends upon the datum. So at A, the datum is present, so the elevation head of A will be 0. Okay, now the elevation head of C. The elevation head of C will be what? Minus Z, because it is below the datum at a height Z. And the elevation head of B will be minus H. So the total head is coming out to be H1. H1 plus Z minus Z, then again H1. And here H1 plus H minus H, again H1. So what we have seen that if we change the datum, the pressure head is not changing, it is same. H1 was previous, H1 again. H1 plus Z was for the previous datum, H1 plus Z for the new datum. H1 plus H for the new datum, for the previous datum, H1 plus H for the new datum. But the elevation head and the total head are changed. So we can write down that assumption of datum at different locations will not change the pressure head, but rather will change the elevation head and the total head. So after drawing this, we can write this statement. So what we have seen that assumption of, sorry, I will change the marker, the ink is not proper. Again. Okay, so the assumption of the datum, sorry, the assumption of datum at different locations. This is the statement what we have got from the previous analysis. Now we have two more cases when the downward flow is happening and when the upward flow is happening. Second is this also we will take 3 points as the previous case, A, C, B. This is water, this is soil. Again, we will insert the piezometers here to find out the pressure heads. Okay, so when the seepage is happening like this, when the water is flowing, here the water table, here the water pressure will be more than the pressure where the water table has been stagnant, so it will be somewhat over here. Because the pressure here is more than the atmospheric pressure. Now, as we go below, the water will lose its energy, so the availability of the head of water at point C will be less than the head of the water at point A. So it will rise somewhat around at this point, and in B the water table will fall, the water will fall in the piezometer much below. Okay, so this height will be how much? So from here to here, this is the total water lost in the soil. This is the soil from A to B, this is the total head of the water which has been lost. So if I write it as HL, okay. So we will say that for the total length of the soil, the loss will be same per unit length. So if the height is H, this is H1, this is H1. So the total head loss, if the total head loss to be happening is HL, then the total head loss, this head loss has to happen in a height H. So up to height Z from the A, from the, to the depth Z, how much loss has been occurred? HL by H into Z. In H length, HL has to occur. So in Z length, how much has occurred? HL by H into Z. HL by H is what? Head loss, your loss of head upon the length of soil. So the length, this would be governed by I into Z. So this one, this much is how much? I into Z. And HL is equal to what? HL in HL by H into capital H. So this will be equal to HL. So this can be written as I into H. Fine. Now we will write down the total stress and the pore pressure at different levels. The total stress first we will write. Here it will be 0, here it will be gamma W into H1. Here it will be gamma W into H1 plus gamma sat into HZ, sorry. And here it will be gamma W H1 plus gamma sat into capital H. Now, pore water pressure. These are all the losses in the pore water pressure only, I into Z, I into H. So U is equal to 0 over here. At this point it will be gamma W into H1, because up till this point no loss has occurred. Up to point A no loss has occurred. So if we go from point A to point C, the loss has occurred of I into Z. So H1 plus H minus I.